A very good evening and good morning to all the participants. We are going to start today's session. In today's session, we are going to start with enterprise asset management. So we'll go ahead with the enterprise asset management. I hope all the participants are able to see my screen. Thank you. So, enterprise asset management. So, the enterprise asset management supports organizations to manage entire life cycle of physical assets. Which results in reduced operating costs and it also better managed capital expenditure and include EHS. I hope all the participants are able to see my screen. Because I just got a message, participants cannot see my screen. Is it okay? Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. And also, it includes the asset utilization. Enterprise asset management integrates with ERP, and operational and operational technology systems. And which supports preventative maintenance. Remote monitoring asset utilization real-time analytics preventative maintenance. Enterprise asset management supports remote monitoring, asset utilization, real-time analytics, and preventative maintenance, etc. The primary capability for enterprise asset management, capital portfolio, and project management. Asset operation and maintenance. An asset network and environment health and safety. Enterprise asset management It has the life cycle management of the physical assets of an organization. And it also includes design, construction, operations and maintenance. An enterprise asset management allows to manage their assets related to costs and risk performance. With S/4HANA, organizations can build a foundation for operational excellence with asset management and environment, health and safety capabilities. In SAP S/4HANA, enterprise asset management allows organizations to manage their cost, risk, and performance, and organizations can implement proactive maintenance strategies that are available for real-time data. As well as it also has the predictive capabilities. To increase the return on assets and to reduce the plant downtime. We can manage the entire life cycle of your physical assets with the complete enterprise asset management. With SAP S/4HANA, organizations can systematically reduce risk and improve the worker safety with one common view of project risks that are mainly related to workers, assets, or environment. In addition to this, it also has a very good improved analytics in a Fury apps. It has improved analytics and predictive models enable the organization to analyze large data sets in order to improve an environment, safety, and health purpose. Now let us see in SAP Fury apps, what are the apps provided by SAP for enterprise asset management. So let me log into Fury apps. So there are some apps that are related to enterprise asset management. They are Create Equipment, Create Maintenance Notification, Change Maintenance Notification, Change Maintenance Orders, these are the few apps developed in the enterprise asset management, and in the backup system UI. IH01, IE01. IW22 and IW32. These are the apps in SAP Fury and T-codes in SAP S4 HANA. In enterprise asset management, mainly fossil location structure, equipment master record, notifications, business objects, functional locations, which is an organizational unit in the logistics. It structures the maintenance objects of a company supporting to functional, project related, special criteria. The functional location represents the place The maintenance charge is to be performed and represents system area at which the object can be used. Now this object that can be installed at functional location are called as pieces of equipment. They're known as pieces of equipments in the SAP system. We can define and manage each functional location in plant maintenance components in a separate master record. We can build up a separate maintenance query for each functional location and you can specify the structure according to your own company criteria using hierarchical labels, so a company can easily represent systems or operational structures from a functional point of view. The hierarchical structure of the functional location can represent the interrelations of operational functions within the system. Now, equipment master record equipment is nothing but the individual object in the system that is maintained independently. Equipment can be installed at different functional location. You can create individual equipment in an organization based on object-based structure of a technical system. Using the equipment, we can perform many functions like you can manage individual data, for the maintenance perspective in the SAP system, for each technical object. Equipment master records can be used in the functional areas like material management, sales and distribution, production planning, and also controlling. These are the different functional application areas where the equipment records can be used. By using the equipment master record, we can create notifications. Notification is created a new mission in the production line is not working properly, then create the notification. For the maintenance department, then the maintenance department will check the machine and fix the problem if possible. After you create the notification, you create the maintenance request. Your equipment to record the functions. So once the notification is created, then we have to create a maintenance order through your notification. For the maintenance department. So after you create the maintenance order, when the maintenance planner need to plan maintenance order, and the order is already created, we can change the existing order and perform the planning. So once you completed the planning, and finally we can release this order. Now, next, create functional location structure in the enterprise asset management. Now, let's log into the SAP logon. Double click on S for ideas. Provide the username and password. Click enter. Let us log into SAP GUI. To create the functional location structure, enter the T code. So here you have the structure indicator. Functional location structure indicator to know about the structure indicator. Select the functional structure indicator. Now, functional location category M. Select as M. Functional location category is an organization that structures the maintenance organizations of a category. Mainly it is related to the process orientation. Functional location is a place where the functional activity is carried on. Here you can see we are creating a functional location based on the copy reference. Click on copy reference and provide the functional location. Here we need to take the reference and provide. And here we need to provide the new functional location mode. Now click continue. So here you can see the functional location called central services, central services management 08. Now click on. A function location is created. Enter the function location mode 1708. Let us go back. Enter the decode IH01. Now enter 1708. Click execute. Now here we can see the functional location that we just created now. Click on expand levels. So here you can see all the functional levels. After creating structure for the production plant, you can create the production line. Let us create the functional reference for the production line. IL01. Click enter. Provide the functional location. FL02. Click enter. Provide the description, production line, now on organization, select the cost center, enter. Select the cost center and click save and click continue. A function location has been created. Now let us copy the functional location FL02. The production line. Let us go back. Now we are going to create the equipment master record. equipment can be installed at different functional location. You can create different equipment based on the organization structure. Using an equipment, we can manage the existing data from the maintenance perspective. We can also perform the individual maintenance for each equipment on the system. To create an equipment master record, enter the T code IE01. So here we're creating the, now provide the equipment number over here. And click enter, provide the description. Select the object type. Provide the amount over here. Provide the currency. And click on location. Select the location. Select the work center. Select the work center. Now click on organization. Cost center, click on start search. Select the cost center over here. Click the assets. Click on start search. Now select the panel group. Click on structure. Click on change instant location. Provide the functional location. Click on start search. So here we can select the functional location. And click confirm. Now click save. Equipment master record is created with a member. Copy this. Equipment master record is created. Copy this member. To see the equipment master record, let's go back. Enter the T code. IE03. Let us copy the equipment master record number. You can see the equipment number over here. Let us click enter. Here you can see the description. Status. You provided the amount 1000 and the currency the INR. Click on organization. The company code is 1710. Accept. So here you have the cost center and the controlling area. Plant and the planner group. Click on the structure. So here you can see the functional location. So this is the equipment details. After creating the equipment, we'll create the notification. So now we'll create the notification. To create the notification, let's go back again. Expand logistics. Expand plant maintenance. Now we are going to create the notification and maintenance processing and notification. Double click on W21. Notification is the part of the cross application component that allows to process and maintains different types of information. Provide the notification type. Select the notification type and click enter. Let's provide the description. Provide the equipment number over here. Here the equipment number is. Copy the equipment number. Select the planner group. 100. We'll select main box enter. Plant is 1710. Click on start search. Select the work center. Reported by, click on start search. Select the username. Now let us provide the priority, high priority. Now click on save. Click yes. Notification is saved. Copy the notification number. Paste it in the notepad. Up to now we created the function location and equipment master record. And we created the notification. After creating the notification, we're going to create the maintenance order. We want to see all the notifications for maintenance order about the entire workflow regarding the maintenance department. We can see the notification list by creating the maintenance order. We are going to create a maintenance order. Enter. So here we have create the notification. Here we can see the notification number What are the notifications we created? Click enter. Provide the description. Click on the create icon. So the planning plant is 1710. Now click continue. Now provide the work duration. Let's provide 20. Provide the operation duration and the control key. Set the control key. So here you can select the control key. PM01. Now click on save. Now maintenance order is created. 000041. With the notification. So here you have the order and here you have the notification. Let's go back. Once the maintenance order is created, the maintenance planner should provide the order. Now we are going to use the to plan the maintenance order. So let us again double click on. Let's expand the order. Double click on IW32. So click enter. Now let us enter the planner group and notification number. The functional location which we created 1708. So here you can see all the details. Now let us click on the operations. Now here you can see the description. And the control key is PM01. Click on components. Click on components. Enter the component over here. Component is FG29. Provide the description. Let us take FG29. Like pink. So provide these details. And click enter. Order is saved. Now we have to release the maintenance order. To release the maintenance order, again click on change, click enter, let us see the status. Material available did not check. Click on put in process. Now let us release the order. Here you can see the status as finished. And here you can see the equipment number. Already in the list. In today's session, we are mainly focusing on how to create the functional location structure and equipment master record and notification, and how to create maintenance order to your notification, and how to plan the order, and finally showing you different kinds of notifications. EWM in S/4HANA. So EWM is nothing but extended warehouse management in S/4HANA. In this session, we'll mainly discuss about transitions of warehouse management functionality from SAP ERP warehouse management to SAP extended warehouse management. Extended warehouse management in S/4HANA. The evolution of warehouse management primarily focus on processes like goods receipt, internal transfer, and goods issue, and inventory warehouse management. Warehouse operations focus on the processes like goods receipt, internal transfer, goods issue, and inventory warehouse management. Goods receipts is from sources such as vendor, other plants and customer, etc. The movement of materials from one place to another within the warehouse is nothing but the internal transfer. Goods issue is nothing but to the customer and vendor for subcontracting production of folders, etc. Inventory warehouse management is counting of stock, these warehouse operations are closely linked with the procurement, production, sales, and distribution. Which are processes in the mainly the supply chain and also with the financial accounting. supply chain. Supply chain and financial accounting. This is the valuation of warehouse management. So this is how it is evolved. It also includes development options. And the corresponding benefits. There are mainly three deployment options. SAP EWM. One is EWM on EWM on SAP SCM server and SAP EWM standalone and third one is SAP EWM add-on. These are the three deployment options for SAP EWM. Now let's see evaluation of extended warehouse management in SAP S/4HANA. SAP released its first enterprise edition of SAP S/4HANA in the year of 2015. That is 15.11 edition, which has warehouse management component. Which is same as the SAP ERP WM. The SAP S/4HANA 1610 extended warehouse management embedded in SAP S/4HANA. 1610 version. EWM is embedded in the SAP S/4HANA. From 2017, this 1709 traditional warehouse management functionalities is also available in SAP S/4HANA. Along with the embedded EWM. However, SAP recommends that to migrate embedded EWM in S/4HANA. EWM is the default warehouse management system in SAP S/4HANA. All development is the warehouse management functionality is being done only in Excellent warehouse management. In Excellent warehouse management, there are two types of deployment options for EWM with SAP S/4HANA. One is known as embedded EWM. The second one is decentralized EWM. These are the two types of deployment options for EWM with SAP S/4HANA. Deployment of decentralized EWM with SAP S/4HANA, which is similar to SAP EWM, development with SAP ERP. That is, the master data transfers from SAP ERP into SAP S/4HANA EWM. Master data, which is transferred from ERP to EWM, is transferred through CIF, Core, IF. This Core IF enables data between the ERP system. CEF is used to transfer master data. And to transfer the transaction data, we use QRFC. QRFC is nothing but remote functional call. This is to exchange the inbound and outbound delivery data which is mainly used to transfer transaction data. This is also same in the SAP S/4HANA. QRFC is used to transfer transaction data S/4HANA to EWM. Decentralized warehouse management can provide a number of business benefits. The SAP also provides the option of decentralized deployment SAP EWM with SAP S/4HANA. Even though EWM can be embedded into S/4HANA in the 16.10 edition, it is mandatory to integrate customer and vendor to the DD. And SAP S/4HANA. The customers and vendors in SAP S/4HANA Digital Core these business partners must be transferred to decentralized EWM decentralized model of EIM. Master data includes material, customer, vendor, transaction data is nothing but the inbound and outbound delivery Let's see the evaluation of embedded extended Windows management in SAP S/4HANA. So until now we have seen transitions of warehouse management functionality from SAP ERP warehouse management to SAP extended warehouse management. Now let's see the valuation of new embedded external warehouse management. Embedded EWM accepts the master data, that is business partner, which includes customers, vendors, materials, batch master, etc. And it customizes the data directly in SAP S/4HANA. There are certain transaction objects which are not required to be replicated to EWM. As it is the case for decentralized EWM, the extended ERP in bulk delivery, notification, in decentralized EWM. However, this application is not required for embedded EWM in SAP S/4HANA. SAP has categorized functionalities of embedded EWM as basic and advanced concepts. Let us see the advanced functions in SAP S/4HANA. So I'll continue with this logo. Click on continue. Enter SPRO. Click enter. Click on SAP reference IMG. Expand SCM External Warehouse Management, External Warehouse Management, and SCM Basis. External Warehouse Management and all these processes which are master data, billing, monitoring, etc. We can see integration, alert notification engine, or let us log into ECC. Click on logistics execution and the warehouse management. Here we have external warehouse management. Let's expand this. For this warehouse management, written S/4HANA. External warehouse management. Now Let's see the difference between external warehouse management embedded EWM. Single step way. And picking activities. But in today's warehouses in SAP S/4HANA, the warehouses have multi-step activities. Traditional warehouses allows static processes. Embedded warehouses allows dynamic processes. And these embedded warehouse management allows reduced operating cost and error. Mainly focusing on the reduced operating cost and errors. But in traditional warehouses, the warehouses focus on key performance indicators. And compared to the normal EWM, the embedded EWM performance is very, very high. The basic and inventory management process, outbound process, physical inventory. These are the basic warehouse functions. The advanced warehouse functions, inventory management, optimization, Single Person Optimization and Outbound Process Optimization. Material flow control, error spelling, etc. These are the advanced variable functions which we have seen here, the basis functions. Physical inventory, physical inventory area, BSNS services, number and variables management, physical inventory. It includes the advanced various functions in the embedded various management in the SAP S/4HANA. These are the differences between the SAP EWM and embedded EWM. Basically, here you can see the advanced warehouse management, basic warehouse management, if we don't want the advanced warehouse management, basic warehouse management, then you can select no acknowledgement. The SAP S/4HANA embedded it provides a very flexible functionality in the entire concept, which are different from ERP warehouse management. Level master data are same in the most use cases. These are the made with the migration of embedded EWM in SAP S/4HANA. let us give the overview of the today's session. In today's session, we have discussed about the evaluation of warehouse management and extended warehouse management and evaluation of new embedded extended warehouse management with SAP S/4HANA and the difference between the SAP warehouse management and the extended warehouse management in SAP S/4HANA. And we have seen what are the advanced warehouse functions, came up with the embedded EWM, and what are the changes made in embedded EWM in SAP S/4HANA. Now, let me show assignments to the participants. So let us go to the Dropbox. Go to Dropbox. In Set to folder, go to Set to assignment. Go to S/4HANA assignment. Go to S/4HANA logistics. Here you can see Enterprise Asset Management, how to create an equipment master record, and how to create maintenance order. Let us open the assignment. Here we can see step-by-step process for to create a notification. Go to this path. On this initial screen, create notification. Enter for notification type and click enter. Here you will get create PM notification screen. In this, provide the description. On the reference object screen, in the equipment field, enter the equipment number . In this you can see all the steps to create notification and to create maintenance orders and to delete the order. Thank you all the participants. I'll see you in the next session.